text that we chose for today, and I'm looking at a particular portion of the scripture that God has given to you to read to everyone else. And in that portion of the scripture, according to Philippians chapter 4, we want to look through it and begin to talk to ourselves today. For this very short meeting that we'll be discussing, I want us to put to mind what God is saying to us through the writer Paul. Paul, an apostle of Jesus, that was anointed after Jesus and left the earth, and he was anointed for a mission, for a cause, for a particular reason. And he was doing the evangelist to the other areas. If you remember when Jesus Christ was living, he said to his disciples, he said, go into the world. He said, preach the gospel to every corner of the world and every place in the world. Go and preach that. And so Paul was anointed as one at the time of the gospel, because Paul had a mission, but the mission was the mission that was directed to the wrong part. And at a point in time in Paul's life, he got to the point where he had to stop and go back to direct his path towards the right path. And by the time Paul was the salvation that he needed, he ran with the whole thing. And at the time he was writing the book of Philippians, to the letter to the Philippians, Paul was himself incarcerated, was not free, was not a free man, was not a man that had enjoyed freedom. And so Paul was in a situation where God was revealing to him every step of his life. God was telling to Paul that, Paul, this prison you have entered, you are not coming out of it. You are going to end in this prison. And Paul saw that. And he felt, I still need to reach to God before my end come. And so he started writing letters to the churches that created and to the churches that would he was telling all sorts of things about. And this was such a letter that he wrote to the church in Philippi. And the passage that we read today, and in particular verse 4, Paul, the man that was in prison, Paul, the man that had been told was not going to come out of it, Paul, the man that had been told was going to end his life in that prison, now goes to the people of Philippi and said, rejoice in the Lord always. He says, I will say to you, rejoice.
Praise the Lord, oh my soul. He says, let everything that is
nothing of today, but one day with the Father, through him of his spirit, crossing up of salvation, he came down from heaven, and the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Father of heaven, and was saved on him. For the same was thank you.
The Lord is the keeper, the Lord is the shade. At your right hand, the sun shall not smite you by day, nor the moon by night.
and she will with all the thanks for doing your adoration for your song. Now everyone that's come is celebrated. Father, thank you because you have granted joy of seeing 60 years in the land of living. Not by power, not by might, but by name of Jesus. As you think of the path, you will find Jesus walking for you in the name of Jesus. You will find help that there is no help in the name of Jesus. Mountains you love on account of you in the name of Jesus. Hearts you refuse on account of you in the name of Jesus. And you have the next to tell the path of shame in the name of Jesus. The Lord Himself will surprise you beyond your own imagination in the name of Jesus. That's what you desire in your heart. My God will bring you fulfillment in the name of Jesus. And God will do what's not going to do for you in the name of Jesus. I pray that as you come this new year, you will not be able to do that in the name of Jesus. You will increase in self-help in the name of Jesus. Your mind will not be troubled in the name of Jesus. Because my God will give you some time in the name of Jesus. Nothing will make you afraid in the name of Jesus.
I'm a student, so I'm a student there. I'm going to be Okay. Kumi, look up. Okay.
You do.
MRE, opposite.